Dear student, this is question number 24 from S.E. Verma, chapter number 3, Kinematics. In this question, a ball is dropped from a balloon going up at a speed of 7 meters per second. If the balloon was at a height 60 meters at the time of dropping the ball, how long will the ball take in reaching the ground? Let's see, in this diagram, I have drawn a simple diagram of balloon. And ball is dropped from the balloon. Balloon is moving up with a speed 7 meter per second. And balloon is at a height 60 meters from the ground. Now, what is the basic concept behind this question? Concept is, when balloon is moving up, ball is dropped from the balloon. It means, at the time of drop, ball will gain some velocity, that is the velocity of balloon, that is 7 meter per second. That's why I have drawn this type of diagram. Little bit speed it will gain, and after that it will come back on the ground. We need to calculate the net speed on the ground. We know when you calculate or prove symmetrically at this point and this point, you will get at this point or this point, you will get the same speed, but only difference of the direction. Here speed is upward direction, here speed is downward direction. You know, sign convention is very important here. I am just assuming sign convention downward. I am taking negative sign and upward I am taking positive sign. Any sign convention you can apply here, but it is important. Now, first of all, I want to calculate the time. What is the thing which is given here? G is already given, having direction downward. G is given. Suppose that is 9.8 meters per second square. Acceleration is given, initial velocity is given, height is given, but time is not given. You need to calculate the time. That's why if acceleration is constant near to the earth, we can write, if g is constant, this is uniformly accelerated motion. That's why using v square minus, no, you have to use another one, it's not useful. You have to use h is equal to, h means downward direction from the reference point. This is the reference point, that's why downward direction it will be negative. U, that is upward direction, that is positive. U is 7 into t plus half g is downward direction, that's what is negative, 9.8 into t square. Now put the value of h, that is 7 and not 7, that is 60, which is equal to 70 minus half, 2 will cancel out, that is 9.8 into t square. Simplify it, that will be minus 60 is equal to 70 minus 4.9 t square. It is quadratic equation. If it is quadratic equation, you can write 4.9 t square minus 70 minus 60 is equal to 0. Now you have to solve it. Simply you can solve by root t is equal to minus b, that is 7, plus minus, here you need to calculate b square, that is 49, plus 4.9 into 60, here 4.9 into 60, 2400, 24 into 49, 24 into 49, you should solve here, 36.3 196, here it is 49. Finally, it will be 686, and decimal will cancel out because 4 is 4.9 and c is minus 60, minus minus become positive, then it become 6 into 4, 24, 24 decimal will cancel out by 0, 49 into 24, 9 4s are 36, 4 4s are 16 or 3, 196, and that is 8, 98. It is not 996, it is 6, 7, 11, 11, 7, 6. 11, 7, 6 plus 49, that will be 9, 6, 15, 2, 12, 25. Finally divided by 2, A is 4.9. Now solve it. T is equal to, only positive sign you have to take because time never be negative. That's why it is root 1225 upon 9.8. Finally, it will be 7 plus root of 1225 is 35. That's why you have to write here 35 divided by 9.8. Finally, it will be 35 plus 7, 42. 42 upon 9.8. Finally, we will write 420 upon 98. Now solve it. 7, 6 are 42. 7 ones are 7, 2, 7 fours are, and now that will be 30 upon 7, and finally time can be 7 fours are 28 plus 2, 7.28, and finally it will be 4.3 seconds. This is the time after which it will reach at the ground. Thank you very much.